Hey everyone, I'm just going to do a quick video that is going to highlight the three previous watches I've reviewed utilizing the macro lens that I purchased, just to kind of give you an update for each of those on really close-up details. So here we go. So first, let's get close up with the Squale. You can see right here, it's a really nice finished aluminum blue aluminum bezel insert with the printed numbers, and you can see the nice finishing on the bezel there, really nicely done. The bead blasting looks really fantastic. Moving on to the rest of the case, you can kind of see here the side of the case, bead blasted, really well done. And you can see the beveling on the lugs. Really, really nice. So, moving on to the dial. Here we go. You can see kind of how the blue changes colors. Really nice matte blue color. The printing is all really nice. See the hands, the orange, how it really pops, and the Van Buren crown there. You can also see how the portion around the inside of the dial is all that matte bead blasted as well, so they even bead blasted that portion of the case. It looks really nice. This was made in the second ticks, minute ticks. See how the lume is painted on, and we can really get a look here at the date aperture. So really clean, nice clean line around it. And I'll flip it over really quick and get us a look at the back. So you can see it is there's the number. You can kind of see it is lightly etched. It's not really deep, but it's still well done and classy. So let's move on from the Squale, and we'll go on to the Marathon, which was our second review. So let me get the buckle of the Squale first. So here's the buckle of the Squale. Alright, on to the Marathon. And here we have the Marathon. You can see the brushed case, and here's where that bezel really seems to pop, and the brushing that was really nicely done, and the integrated bezel into the case. Clean lines. Very nice. Let me kind of wipe this off a little bit. Kind of see here now the tritium tubes and the really clean printing on the dial. Really well done. The numbers and the second and sub-second marks. Really clean. Second hand there, and you can really see the tritium tube there at the 9 o'clock. Looks really, really nice. You can see the size of the case, the lugs. And let's look at the case back really quick. And this should really show off the printing. Military spec printing really well. Come on, focus. Just a second here, I'm gonna try to get this focused. There we are. It's not deeply printed in there, it's pretty lightly etched. but cleanly done. All right, and we'll move on to the Steinhardt. So first I'm going to show you the bracelet on the Steinhardt. Now you see the brushing. And get that to show. You can kind of see, there we go, let's see if we can see it there. Really fine brushing on the bracelet. You can see how it's held up on the clasp really well to the desk. No desk diving marks there. You can see the polished bit with my fingerprint. You can see how the Steinhardt logo is stamped in there. And then on the watch itself. So first you can kind of see the domed crystal there, really nice dome to it, and then the ceramic bezel insert, and you can see how the numbers aren't engraved into the bezel insert, they're just printed on. And with the bezel, you can kind of see how the teeth are pretty well machined. Well done. The DLC, it's hard to see with the case, the brushing and the polish. Polished side there. Alright, so on the dial, again, you can see that kind of matte dial finish, and you can see the loom applied indices. Let me get the cloth out again really quick. Wipe this down. Alright, here we go. You can see the print is well applied, really clean, well detailed. The date aperture. With the blacked out look, it actually kind of looks better, I think, without having the date aperture framed. And then the hands. So there we are, everyone. The DLC case back didn't really show very well, but I hope you all enjoyed getting a bit of a close-up, detailed look of the watches from the previous reviews, and I'll be using that lens in more detail for the rest of the watch reviews I do from here on out. Until next time.